Let's get that background out of here. Hello, my background hating PD peeps. Thanks for choosing this tutorial to improve your background removal skills with PowerDirector. When you want to use an object or person in a picture, but you don't want to use the entire image, removing the background is a perfect way to isolate an object and use it however you want. As you can see, I have a clip of a young buck, a soccer athlete, jogging. He's on track one. Now, I want to add a soccer ball to the scene, but all I have is this. It's a picture of a soccer ball in the grass. So I need to remove the grass from the photo so I can make it happen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to left click on this soccer ball, hold down my left mouse button, and I'm going to drag this down to track two. Now I'm going to go ahead and stretch out the duration by placing my cursor over the end of this photo until I see two arrows pointed in opposite directions. I'm going to hold down my left mouse. I'm going to drag this out so that the duration matches. Now I want to go to Tools. And then I want to go to Mask Designer. Now here there is an option and it's called Custom Painted Mask. So I'm going to click on the Custom Painted Mask button. And there's a bunch of options on here, but the easiest, quickest way to get this done is by just clicking on Auto Object Selection Tool. When you click on this, PowerDirector tries to find the part of the image that it's going to focus in on, and then it tries to isolate that part and remove everything else from the photo. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And I'm going to click on OK. Now what I want to do is move this ball over so I can just place my cursor over the preview window until I see these crosshairs, hold down my left mouse, and I can drag the ball to where I want it to show up on the screen. Now, if you want to animate the ball in any type of way, like me, I want the ball to kind of zoom in from infinity. So what you can do is you can double click on the ball. And then you can go ahead and move your cursor all the way to the end. And for scale, we're going to click on add keyframe. And that means that the ball will be at this size when it gets to this keyframe. And we also want to go ahead and move our playhead to a position where we want the ball to make sure that it stays and it stops moving or scaling up. So I'm going to do about a second and a half, which for my timeline is 1 second and 12 frames. And I'm going to add another scale keyframe here. Now I'm going to move my playhead all the way to the beginning. And here I'm going to make the ball almost invisible on the screen by scaling it down to a very small number. So I'm going to go up here to Object Settings. And I'm going to go to Scale. And I'm just going to drag this to the left all the way down to the bottom. So what that means is at this point on this keyframe, the ball is almost invisible because it's so small. But as we move our playhead forward, you'll see the ball gets larger. And then once it hits the second keyframe that we created, which was 100% scale, it's just going to stay that way. So since I'm done, I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And now we can play this back and see what it looks like. Bye-bye, background. If you like what you see, I'll leave links to try PowerDirector for free and buy PowerDirector in the video description. Using those links helps to support the channel so I can make more content for you. I want to send a shout out to Team PDU for their support and for clicking the join button under this video. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.